What sort of relationship do you want now with the United States?
Saludo, Larry.
First of
Larry
all,
the King.
Hi, Larry. Larry King. Larry King or Larry
the King?
King.
Anyway,
the
like.
King.
Mira, nosotros, yo creo que es lo que quiere el mundo. Larry.
Well, us and the whole world, we want relations based on respect. Relations of equals, where we are respected. Most governments in the United States in 100 years have not respected the peoples of Latin America. They have sponsored coup d'etats, assassinations. It's enough. We want to be brothers and sisters. We want respect and equality. Simon Bolivar, our father, said a balanced world. A universe in a balanced universe in order to have peace and development.
Do you expect it to be better with President Obama? Because you called him there, you said there are two Obamas. What do you mean?
Bueno, ya lo explicaba yo allí.
I explained this already. We have an Obama that talked about peace yesterday
to
sponsor peace, to promote peace as one of the pillars of its foreign policy. I accept this calling, and we join him in this calling for peace. However, there is another Obama, the one who approved the installation of 7 military bases. That's another Obama, the Obama sponsoring war, using force and the presence of military officers and using the U.S. weaponry against the Latin America. We want the Obama of peace. I shook hands with that Obama. That's the Obama we want. The world needs a true leader, an Obama that promotes peace and understanding in the world.
But don't you add to it when you call President Bush a devil, or you call, as you call President Obama once, an ignoramus. Don't you think that insults, Mr. President, don't harbor peace?
Well, if you talk about insults and name calling, well, if we withdraw the insults and those name calling, then we can have peace? Well, we need to do that, but all of us. Now, how Bush called me?
A mí me tumbó el gobierno de Bush.
The U.S., the Bush government toppled me. They asked for my assassination. They disrespect us.
Sencillamente uno responde.
We reply in a firm manner, in a hard manner, but it's not the way you call a president or a human being. I said today, it doesn't smell sulfur anymore in the United Nations. I want that we have new winds of warmth, of hope.
Now,
who has been insulted is us. Bush aggressed and abused the world.
How do you know they tried to assassinate you? How do you know that?
I saw my assassins. At dawn, I was a prisoner in Venezuela, being a president. They took me to the seaside. I was debating with those who wanted to murder me. They received the order to kill me. However, at this very moment, a group of soldiers refused. They did not kill me, but I saw those who wanted to kill me. And the order came from the White House. There is no doubt in my mind. The same thing as the order to kill Salvador Allende and to kill Che Guevara and to kill Omar Torrijos, and the same thing to bombard Panama, Nicaragua, the Dominican Republic. That's our history, and we want a new time. We want peace.
Be that as it may, true or not, but that's the past. Let's look to today. You are spending, billions buying new weapons, large amounts from Russia, reports say tanks and rockets. Why does your country need all these weapons? What is the threat to Venezuela?
Bueno, eso es un cuento que tienen por ahí.
Well, that's a story they are telling around. All countries have a defense system. The United States have one. How much do you spend in weapons daily? Atomic bombs, steel planes. Who is the country that is sponsoring war around the world? Now, Larry, for a long time, Venezuela has bought these F-16 planes manufactured in the United States. They do not sell us, however, their spare parts. So most of them cannot fly. Transportation planes, you don't sell us the spare parts. Also surveillance planes to fight against drug trafficking. The U.S. government does not sell us their spare parts. Now we have resorted to other options. To have at least the minimum required for our defense. But who can accuse us of arms race? The United States?
But who do you, the United States?
That's ironical.
The United States had a 9/11. Who do you fear? Who do you fear is going, what country is going to harm you?
¿Ha tenido qué?
What did you say?
Country?
9/11.
What country do you fear will harm you?
El Imperio.
The Empire.
El Imperio.
The Empire.
7 bases militares.
7 military bases, gringo military bases in Colombia. That's a serious threat against Venezuela.
Hay que ver la realidad.
Let's see the reality.
Hay que ver la realidad.
That's the reality.
Colombia,
the Colombian government, for instance, attacked Ecuadorian territory a year ago based on the principle of the preventive war. The same used by Israel to attack the Gaza Strip. Venezuela has the largest oil reserve, and Venezuela has to defend itself. That's what we are doing. Now, I repeat, who can criticize us? The United States? What's on what ground? That Venezuela is equipped with the minimum required to defend itself, to assure the sovereignty of its country. Can you criticize that?
You have a close relationship with Iran, and there have been huge protests in Iran over the past election. Why do you support a government who's had so much bloodshed, whose presidential election is in question? Why do you support Iran?
Nos apoyamos mutuamente.
Well, we support each other, and we have the right to do that. We are sovereign nations.
Bueno, porque tenemos una excelente relación de
because we have an excellent cooperation relation in the fields of health. We manufacture medicines, technology transfer for food production. In Venezuela, we're installing milk processing plants to develop agriculture, to produce food. We have political cooperation. Now, the internal situation in Iran, that's internal situation. I do not meddle in those internal situations in affairs in Iran. And the same thing with Iran. The same thing with the U.S. You have relations with many countries. Who is going to blame the U.S. for having relations with dictators and monarchs? Israel, for instance, the United States. You support Israel, and Israel is a genocidal government. Iran has not invaded anyone. The Iranians have a revolution. The previous leader was the Shah. There is a democracy in Iran with the Islamic style, but you have to be respectful.
You said in Tehran on a recent trip that the Iranian government is going to help your government develop nuclear technology. Why do you need nuclear technology?
I've never said they have fooled you. I've never said that Iran is going to help us to have a nuclear technology. There is the opinion, and that's a strategy to attack Venezuela and say that we are building an atomic bomb. That's the next accusation, and I'm going to say this now. Please, come on, that's crazy. That's crazy.
Now,
I tell you, why you don't destroy your nuclear arms and those people who have those weapons? Obama said that they want a world without nuclear arms. Let me tell you this. We have signed with Russia, with Medvedev, a mechanism to develop in Venezuela nuclear energy. Nuclear energy. That is not a bomb. That's energy. Who manufactured the bomb, the nuclear bomb? The United States and then other countries. Who launched the nuclear bomb on Nagasaki and Hiroshima? We want, as Brazil does, and Argentina, France, and many other countries, we want to develop the nuclear technology for medicine, to develop energy, because one day we will run out of oil. You don't see it. Our grandchildren might see it. We need to invest in technology to generate alternative of energy, and nuclear energy is an alternative.
With President Chavez of Venezuela, your country, of course, very rich in oil, in fact, claimed to have the biggest oil reserves in the world. You're a larger of exporter of oil rather to this country, the United States. Doesn't your economy need America?
We all need America. America needs us, and we need America. That's for sure. Yes, we are large oil exporters.
Isn't it in your best interest to have a peace with America, to be in concert with America? I mean, you're interdependent.
Claro.
Yes.
Pero por supuesto.
Mira, no doubt.
Yo en mi primer periodo de gobierno,
in my first government, I had good relations with Clinton. I came to the White House. We met here in New York several times. We spoke on the phone, and I said to Obama, and I said to Mrs. Clinton in Trinidad, I want to be as close with you as I was with Mr. Clinton. The thing is that Bush destroyed everything with the coup d'etat, with the sabotage. He ordered my assassination. They destabilized Venezuela following Bush's orders. We want with Obama to come back to the Clintonian time. Despite all the problems with Bush, we always sent you 1.5 million barrels of oil. And we have here in the United States Citgo that processes 2 million barrels a day. And they provide 10,000 gas stations in the United States. And they have a program to help the poor and the needy, providing healing oil to the poor and needy here, because poverty is very important in the United States.
Will you ever cut off oil to the United States?
I didn't do this at the time of Bush. I will never do this now. But even during the coup, that's my commitment. And we send oil to our company here. That's business. And we are sending oil also to China, to Europe, to the Caribbean, to South America, Venezuela. Larry, our reserves could last 150 years. Once we run out of oil on this earth, there will be four or five countries with available oil: Russia, Iran, Iraq, Saudi Arabia, and Venezuela. The world will depend on us, and we want to entertain the best relations, investing in resources to be able to sustain and to meet the large energy needs of the world. The United States do not have the reserves required. We want to have good relations with the U.S.
With all your oil, why aren't you doing better economically? Why is there poverty in your country and unemployment with all the oil you have? You should be dominant.
Well, let me tell you this.
Venezuela,
when I became president, poverty in Venezuela was almost 60%. Today, it's below 30. We met the millennium goals. Extreme poverty was 24%. Now it's 7% and keep on going down. Unemployment was close to 20%. Now it's close to 6%, better than the U.S. Here, unemployment has increased. The world crisis has not affected us. We have improved employment. The child mortality has improved. And I know that you are a generous person. You have a foundation to help children suffering from heart diseases. I invite you to visit our heart hospital built by the revolution in Caracas, the biggest of the hemisphere. We are operating 1,500 children every year, free of charge. We have a healthcare system that's taking care of 15 million inhabitants, a free distribution of food donated to the poor people, and it serves 40% of the population. Venezuela has changed in a dramatic fashion. We have redistributed the income.
In February, you won a referendum that lifts term limits. Some fear you are power hungry. And you want to be president for life.
No.
Is that true?
No, yo lo que quiero es servirle a mi país.
I want to serve my country as long as my people want.
Nosotros hicimos un referéndum.
We had the referendum.
Esta es una constitución
and this is a constitution that's been in force for 10 years. We have created a participatory democracy, moving away from the liberal democracy, the democracy of the rich and the elite against the poor. The people decided to amend the constitution and opening the possibility not only for the president but also to the mayors, to governors, to the deputies. They can be elected without time limit.
Una democracia completa. Yo no diría completa.
Well, full democracy, no. A democracy in development, in progress. We want to have more democracy, and hopefully one day we achieve full democracy.
President Carter, who you recently mentioned favorably, said recently that you were becoming too authoritarian. He made the remarks in a Colombian newspaper, El Tiempo. He said that Chavez is consolidating all political power in his office at the expense of an independent judiciary. True?
Leí eso.
Yes, I read that and I regret for him. Because I think he's totally confounded and lost. It's a long time since he visited us. I respect him enormously, but I think he's wrong. He's the victim of so much falsehood in the world. He knew Venezuela before Chavez, when there was extraordinary power concentration. We are redistributing power. We need to transfer power to the people. We are creating the people's power. And I wish he visits us and see the communities, he's wrong. I think no one is perfect, of course.
You're inviting him.
I invite him because he's a serious person, and I'm concerned that he's totally wrong now.
How about silencing your critics, Mr. President? Fears you're going to shut down Global Vision, the remaining independent television station in Venezuela. In fact, some say that is a certainty. You're going to close down that television. Are you?
No es cierto que sea el último canal.
It's not the last independent network in Venezuela. We have hundreds of independent networks in Venezuela. Independent are those who do not belong to the state. I mean, they are not independent. They depend on the owners. Of course, they are not independent. There is no freedom of speech. Now, I said to a journalist a while ago, never in Venezuela we had so much freedom of speech as now. You know Chomsky, right? He went to visit us recently. Some Venezuela media supported openly the coup d'etat. They have called for my assassination, such as Pat Robinson said that he had to be murdered. They repeat the same thing. Chomsky said that in the United States, some network, like your network, for instance, where you work, they call for a coup d'etat and to murder the president.
CNN called for this? Are you saying my network did that?
No, no, no. Si lo dijera.
In case you say such a thing, you do such a thing. Chomsky said, what would happen in the United States if something like that happened? Not only they will be closed down, but they will be put in the electric chair.
Didn't you close 32 radio stations?
No,
but not
mentira.
At all. That's a lie.
Mentira.
Again, that's a lie.
Are you?
Listen.
Listen.
Hay una ley.
There is a law.
¿Tú aceptas que hay una ley?
You accept that there is a law,
si yo
right?
Tengo un vehículo,
if I have a car,
ando por las calles de Nueva York,
I drive my car in New York,
contrario al tráfico,
and I go against the rules, the traffic rules, I'm going
si
to be detained. If I
York,
want to drive in a street in New York, 120 miles,
eso es lo que ha ocurrido,
I will commit a crime.
Hay una ley.
and there is a law in Venezuela, those who breach the law, they lose the right to use these networks because they breach the law. But in your country, we have hundreds of radio stations.
Yes or no, my original question, are you going to close Globovision?
No lo sé.
I do not know. It depends on them. If they keep on sponsoring coup d'etats, if they keep on calling for my assassination, if they keep on breaching the law in Venezuela, it is not Chavez who's going to close them. We have to apply the law. We need to respect the law. It is a law. It's out of logic. It means pure logic.
In our limited time left, some personal questions. What do you like about the United States?
El baseball.
Baseball.
La gente.
People. Yesterday, I walked a little bit in New York. And the Secret Service people, they have been very gracious, very efficient, and very attentionate, very kind. We walked with him, with them, and we saw a group of people, women, elderly people greeting us. I love America, the way I like Russia, Venezuela, Argentina. This is part of the world. I like music. Yesterday, I met a lady who sings rock and roll, and we kissed, and I love the movies. Yesterday, we went to see Oliver Stone and a group of actors and actresses, Danny Glover. I love the movies. I was telling a person there that I love the movies of this guy, Charles Bronson. I love this actor, excellent actor. He died and he was very young, still young. The Anonymous Avenger, and baseball, the Yankee Stadium, Wild Whitman. I love them.
You've convinced me. Some other notes before you leave us. Would you invite our president to Venezuela?
Sí, lo invito.
Of course, I invite
ya,
him.
Yo le dije,
anytime. When we met, I told him, Obama,
mano, se la di a Bush,
I gave this hand to Bush 8 years ago. I told him the same thing I'm telling you. I want to be your friend. I wish him to visit us. I met a number of trade union leaders, and they asked me to buy a cracker factory. And we want to have the best of relations, economic, social, with this great country. But not with an empire. So I invite Obama, no problem.
Truth, would you rather have been a Major League Baseball player than president of Venezuela?
Era mi sueño.
It was my dream.
Era mi sueño.
It was my dream. I would have preferred, personally, to do that. However, since you do not decide what you're going to do, I went to the army because I wanted to be a baseball player. I became a soldier. Then Venezuela just shattered, and the wind transformed me a president. But I'm still the young baseball player who wanted to play in the Yankee Stadium.
Would you rather have been a singer?
Me gusta cantar.
I love to sing. Canto muy bien. I'm not very good, a good singer, poeta, of course. A poet. I love poetry, singing, culture.
Are you then misunderstood?
Is
the image of you in America, are we wrong?
I'm just a man with many defects. I love, I sing, I dream. I was born in the countryside. I was raised in the countryside, selling sweets manufactured by my grandmother. I love to live. My children, my two daughters are with me, and I want a better world for my grandchildren, for your grandchildren. Now, they demonize me. But that's part of this world campaign to try to defend what you cannot defend, a system that is destroying the world. What we want, what Jesus Christ wanted. I'm a Christian. I want the world of justice and equality. It's the only way to achieve peace. I was an altar boy. My mother wanted me to be a priest. I'm very Christian and Catholic.
Do you have faith?
Of course, a lot of faith. Yes, I'm very faithful. I believe in God, Jesus Christ. I love Jesus Christ. I am a Christian. And I feel like the cross of Jesus Christ, a world of injustice, inequalities. I cry when I see injustice, people and children died out of hunger. And you should see that. You see that. I know you do. You feel the pain of others. I'm faithful that there will be a better world. That's why I said today, it doesn't smell sulfur anyone. I want to smell a different world, hope, faith, peace. We need to unite. The United States should unite with the South American countries to produce food, medicine, to fight against poverty, to take people out of poverty. That's our goal.